Good evening, this way. Can we just turn the water? Turn the water,
shall
we?
Can you have a quick look?
You can pop in later, have a look.
Surprise!
is it you?
I just got Con to come in to turn a tap off, and fucking Vegas here, I can't believe it.
When I say Steve, you say yeah. Steve!
Yeah!
Steve!
Yeah!
Steve!
Yeah! Yeah!
You fucking idiots, all of you. I can see everybody.
Can you see the wrong you?
I can't believe it.
That's it, you and all.
I can't believe it. Hello, mate. How are you? Lovely to see you, Gary. Thank you very much. Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
I wonder where all my gear had gone.
See you.
basically shut the fuck up.
Stavros, I couldn't help but watch some of your antics at Hampton Downs the last time we were in New Zealand. We had really done some crazy things, trying to break a lap record on a double-decker bus. Hey, good fun whenever you're around, we always have a great time. And have a great birthday, mate. All the best from the Kiwis, and look forward to having you down here soon. Hopefully we'll do a bit more of this sort of stuff. Look out. All the best, mate. Cheers.
Hey, Dad, you got to do this birthday message for Steve Parrish.
From one non-working British classic to Steve Parrish, another non-working British classic. Congratulations, Steve, on 70 laps around the sun and taking the chequered flag. All the very best from us here in Australia. Cheers, mate.
Happy birthday, Steve. Congrats on reaching the ripe old age of 80. You don't look a day over 75, so you can feel good about that. You know, you and I have a lot in common. We both have our birthday on the 24th of February. The obvious success achieved at racing. Actually, no, that's more you. There's obviously the charisma. No, that'll be you too. Sense of humor. No, you too. Actually, just leave it. We share the same birthday. Steve, you're a fabulous guy. I feel honored to know you. And I wish you the very best for your birthday. Speak soon. Bye.
Hi, it's Bruce Coburn, your roving reporter here, broadcasting from the TT Grandstand here on the world-famous mountain course on the Isle of Man. A venue synonymous with the achievements of Steve Parrish, bravery, endeavour, skill and fights with Mick Grant over the sizes of petrol tanks. All these have made Steve a well-known former resident and visitor to these shores. Oh, but wait. News just in, from the world of golf, it's been reported that earlier this year, a 69-year-old man with behavioural issues has dramatically recorded a score of just two shots to complete the notorious 15th hole at Castletown Golf Links, here on the Isle of Man. Apparently, a perfectly struck 6-iron found its way to the bottom of the cup, a hole at which the competitor was already receiving a shot due to having a dodgy handicap. This adds up to 6 Stableford points on the one hole, unheard of in the world of golf, leading to one of his playing partners apparently being quoted as saying, "What a jammy bastard, can I have my £10 back please?" So for me, here on the Isle of Man, your roving reporter Bruce Coburn, it's goodbye and all the best for a happy 70th birthday, Mr. Parrish.
Hi Steve, happy 70th, hope you have an awesome day. And to commemorate your 70th, we have immortalized you here on our wall. I've got to find it. There we go. Hope you have an awesome, awesome day.
Happy 70th, young man. Have a good one. Don't get up to mischief. And here's some champers for you.
Okay. Cheers.
Cheers, cheers, cheers.
Cheers.
Hi Steve, happy 70th birthday. It's been an absolute privilege and honour to share the track and meet you over the years at the SA Classic TT. We look forward to seeing yourself and Michelle in sunny South Africa again in 2024. Have an absolute blessed 70th birthday. Wishing you all the best from East London in South Africa. Cheers.
Hey Steve, happy birthday. I hope you have an awesome day and yeah, we hope to see you again really soon. Cheers.
Hey all, what a great TT that was. Absolutely fantastic. And here's a big happy 70th to Steve from the Okavango Delta. Look forward to seeing you guys all next year. Cheers, guys.
Okay, so now I've been forced into doing this. Happy birthday, Steve. May there be many, many more. We'll see you in a few weeks. Cheers.
Happy birthday, Stavros, from sunny Australia. We had some damn good times together. I never thought we'd even get to 30, you've made 70. The time staying at your mum's were great. I didn't get up to as much trouble as you did. the times we travelled together, even the time when I crashed at Ulster at Deer's Leap and I came back and you thought I was dead, so you're going through my pockets trying to get some money because I hadn't paid for the ticket on the boat. All those things make up the fabric of life. I love you. You're a good man, and happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Steve. Hope you have a really great one. Glad to see you made it to 70, which is unbelievable. And you're looking well, and enjoy your birthday.
What a load of shit, huh?
I'm younger than you, Stephen, and so's he, and so's he, so she. Now that you're 70, enjoy it, pal.
Hi, Steve. It just shows you that age is only a number. And you've arrived at this big 7-0. Good on you. Well done. Do more.
Happy birthday, Steve. Hope your hair lasts. Have a great day.
Happy birthday, Steve. Just shows that at 70 you can still be passed for a Scotsman.
Happy birthday, Steve. Thanks for a great trip. Hope you're having a great day. Nice to see someone your age can still get their leg over. Thanks for all the gags and the giggles and the joke pizza and the puke and the dog shit. Great fun. All the best, buddy. Cheers.
Happy birthday, Mr. Parrish. It's good to know they'll never be able to overtake you either with age or on the trucks.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve. Happy birthday.
Can't believe you're 70.
Hi, Steve. Just would like to wish you a very happy 70th birthday. Hope you have an awesome day. And remember, growing up is optional. Keep on pranking. Cheers. See you next year.
Where did the time go?
Exactly. It's amazing, isn't it, to think even you're 70 now. We're a little bit buster, as you know. But
speak for yourself.
Anyway, it's fantastic. As you can see, we're so sorry we couldn't be there with you today, because it would have been great. But as you can see, we couldn't resist the temptation of coming out here and spending some time in the Canary Islands.
But we have made a lot of effort. Look, four nice T-shirts.
Well, if you start from with Chad, just look at Chad's T-shirt. First of all, Chad, what have you got on that one?
Well, we've got you, me and Joe. We were at Thruxton Truck Day. You're going to take me out in the... a big truck. Unfortunately, it had a lower turbo, so I missed out on that. I was pig sick, actually. We got Eve.
Yeah, mine was my 40th birthday, where you and Charlie did a kissogram for me, and when we were skiing at Valterens.
And mine, of course, is Mallory Park Battle of the Past Masters, and I'm sure you remember that because we had a good old day there. You and I just sort of playing games out on the corner course on the track together. It was great fun. And Annie,
my two favourite men. Hey, happy birthday, Steve.
A shot from Goodwood at the revival a couple of years ago, I think, something like that. Anyway, all together, happy birthday, Steve, and we're going to drink a little toast.
Yep.
All the
happy
best, Steve.
Happy birthday.
Have a great day. I'm sure you'll have something planned.
Hi, Steve, from Brisbane, Australia. First of all, happy birthday, and especially happy 70th birthday. I hope you have a great day. And we can't wait to see you over this end of the world again, or across Pat's Cross in the coming year. So have a great time. All the best to you and Michelle for the future. Take care.
Hi, Steve. Happy birthday. Congratulations on reaching the big 70. A small favour to ask. Make sure you're here another 10 times before you get to the big 80. Other than that, have a wonderful day, man. Thanks. Cheers.
Oh, shite. Where's that damn light switch? There we go, Mr. Parrish. Welcome. You've been to sunny South Africa. The sun's beautiful, the country's beautiful. Our electricity supply is pretty shite. Anyway, I got into bike racing when I was about 8 years old, around about 1983 in Freddie Spencer era. Barry Whistle around. And obviously your name has been there ever since I've been involved with bike racing. It's been an absolute honor to meet you twice. It's been an honor sharing the racetrack with you. And this particular TT I won't forget, because I will have some memories. And I'd just like to wish you all the very, very best for your 70th birthday, Steve. I hope you have an absolutely blessed year, many more healthy, happy years, and we hope to get to see you again in the near future back in South Africa. Take care, sir. Ciao.
Happy birthday, Steve!
Happy birthday, mate! Hey.
Can you believe Steve Parrish's birthday? He's 38.
Blimey, that's got
38 years of old boy, ain't he?
Bloody
I tell you, you can't believe he's 38, can you? Anyway, we've got a cake to celebrate it. Got a nice bit of chocolate cake. I like a bit of chocolate cake. Here we go, look at this, look.
Ooh.
Candles and everything, look! Oh, did you make a wish?
Make a wish, Steve.
Did you make a wish?
Wish,
you don't know what he's wishing for, though, do I? I'll tell you what I'm wishing for.
That's to bugger off.
I'll tell you what I'm wishing for, and I'll tell you what I've got it now.
You've got a bit of goat, though. How come you got a bit of cake when I ain't got a bit?
You've got to lose weight, haven't you? You've got to get in that car and drive.
Well, one bit of cake ain't going to matter, is it?
You're cutting bolts off to save weight. You don't want a bit of the old cakey sponge in you, especially chocolate. I'll do you a favour, mate. I'll sort it out, all right?
I hope he gives the shits.
Tell you what, it's a beautiful bit of goat.
Don't like chocolate anyway.
Yeah. Anyway, why have you only got one apple?
Well, that's what normal people are. How come you've got two? I see. You've had two bits of cake, two hats. You're going full Terry McCann, aren't you?
Full Terry McCann, I am. I'll tell you what.
Happy birthday, Steve.
Happy birthday to you.
I'm going to tell you the one or two things you don't know about him. He's actually got a bit of a temper. And we were playing golf at Jonagorn, and it was about the eighth hole, and Steve looked very close to breaking his record of 130. And he, after about three swipes at the ball, eventually it sort of shot off at 45 degrees and went into the ditch. He then grabbed the club, had four goes at breaking it over his knee, and then threw it, and it went considerably further than the ball went, but ended up a tree. And the admiration I had for him as the ladies' captain, who was next round, came and saw me trying to get this club out of the tree, I explained that there was a problem, and he actually went up to her and said, "I must get that club re-sleeved." He said, "It's the handle's a problem."
What?
Yeah. All I can say is over the last 30 years, it seems, doesn't seem like 30 years ago, we went go-kart racing on your 40th birthday. Mm. He's been an absolutely brilliant neighbour. He's been a brilliant friend. From Claire and I's point of view, we wouldn't have got through COVID without Michelle and Steve. And he's an absolutely first-class chap. I can't believe he's 70. He doesn't look it. He doesn't act it. But he is. And so I ask everyone in this room to raise their glass to Steve Parrish.
Thank you very, very much indeed. I swear to you, and everyone has asked me the same question tonight. Seriously, everyone has said to me, "Did you know anything about it?" And I swear on my children's life, and Frankie and Joe are in the room, I had absolutely no idea. I'll tell you the whole story, shall I? We were around our house last night, and there was a group of friends around there, and we had a curry, and we had a few chats, and this, that, and the other, and everyone went home. I played golf today with my son, Chris, and Dougal, and everything was just very, very normal. But we'd arranged probably about a month ago or 3 weeks ago, we were going to the University Arms Hotel in Cambridge, which I've been telling everyone I was going there, and people said, "Oh, it's a lovely place, restaurant's great, this, that, and the other." So David arranged to pick me up and Michelle at 7 o'clock in the evening, which was about a couple of 3 hours ago. And we set off and we came down the lane. And Claire, I think she used the word, "Oh fuck, I've left the tap on." It might have been bugger, I can't remember. But it was something that was, "I've left the tap on at Clopton where the horses are and we need to switch it off." At which point Dave and I, "For fuck's sake, we're late already." So we swing into Clopton where we are right now. And I must admit, I knew you got some horses around here, but I didn't realise you had to water them and do things like that. But anyway, So we swung in, and then we get pulled up, and Dave turns left, then right, and then left, and then finally we end up where we are, just outside here. And at this point, I still have no idea that anything was going on, but I was mentioning as we drove in that there's a function room here, and Michelle and I had been in here, and we'd looked at it, and it was all very, very nice. And then we pull up, and then Claire finally says, "Bucket, the tap's right in the way down there. Have you got a torch? I've left my phone behind." And I swear, and you can, I'm mature, I am now got my phone and torch on, walking down the side of this building like this. I promise you. And I'm looking in, I go, shit, there's a load of people in there. Must be a function on them. Whatever. So Claire then says, "Oh, well, let's have a look inside, shall we? See what it's like," because she'd never been in here before. Upon which I see so, so many lovely, lovely friends. And I really appreciate you coming here tonight. Thank you so much indeed. It's completely stunned me. I was overwhelmed. Michelle, my lovely wife, who we've been together about 20 odd years now. We've been married four or five, I can't, something like that, isn't it? But I'm still trying to work out, as she is so sneaky, whether she's got another husband somewhere else. Possibly other lovers, I don't really know. I can't imagine she'd want anyone better at it than I am, but anyway. And I also got caught out 10 years ago for my 60th, at another function which was probably 2 miles up the road here, thinking this is never ever going to happen again. And what I've seen here from South Africa, we've just got back from South Africa, clearly you can see they're all pissed because they've got the phone the wrong way round and you can't see what they're up to. Even Howard, that's in the back of the room there. But I've been around the world all my life, met so many lovely, lovely people, and there's some videos up there of all the people that couldn't make it here tonight. But Michelle, you are an absolute diamond. I cannot imagine how you've got away with that, so thank you very much. I'm amazed that somebody, even Charlie Cox turned up, he never goes out anyway. They call him, I think they call him Pilot Light because he never fucking goes out, does he? And he turned up as well. Some of the presents I'm looking at here, and I've got to say there's some wonderful presents, I'm sure, but I've got to say very, very much a great thank you to the lads from the race team at Goodwood. One or two of you, if you've been unfortunate enough to go to one of the theatre shows that we do, there's a story about blowing up the toilets in Finland, and somehow they've managed to retrieve the very toilet seat that we blew up in Finland. It's absolutely amazing. The race team is called So Fucking Close, or it's actually spelled Suffolk and Close, but it looks very much like So Fucking Close. Thank you, lads, for making that down there. That's very, very kind of you. Michelle, you can use that now when you want to. If there's any issues, but thank you very much indeed. I also like to say a great thank you to Ruth, my previous wife, who is here tonight, and thank you very much indeed for Chris to let her make me a beautiful cake here. It is absolutely extraordinary. It's got the Wendy Wankers Tennis Club on it, because we play at Roger, who's here tonight. He is from Wendy, and we're all a bunch of wankers that play at the tennis group. So it's known as that. There is the golf course I can see down the end there. I can't see the golf club in the tree quite, but I'm sure there's one in there somewhere. But it's absolutely brilliant. Ruthie's going to now cut this cake, and it would be great if you were to come and have a piece of my cake. And to say the words that you can't have your cake and eat it, I think I have. Thank you very, very much.
Stop. so, but that's not how it used to be.
Well, how did it used to be?
Oh, that's how it used to be. Well, stop.
Yeah.